Hey everybody, here we are. The Naked Truth. It's a sad day for the Naked Truth. UFC 212 just wrapped and you were going to get our instant reaction, but we're a sad bunch here. I of course am Jed Meshew of MMAfighting.com. Joining me, the co-host of all our adventures and misadventures, a very angry man, Mr. Naked Gambler, TNG. How you feeling right now?
Fuck Max Holloway. Fuck Big John McCarthy. Just fuck it all. This sport is terrible. It's an awful sport. Awful. Fuck you.
I'm certainly not going to dispute that it's an awful sport. So by saying fuck Big John McCarthy, I'm taking it that you're unhappy with the stoppage. Am I reading you correctly there?
Yes, but I gotta add the caveat. I'm wasted as fuck right now, and you shouldn't take anything I say as legitimate. Maybe I'll watch in the morning and be like, huh, the stoppage was fine, actually. I'm completely wrong. But right now, all I can think to myself is Jose Aldo was up 2 rounds. Fuck Max Holloway. Fuck Big John McCarthy. Fuck you, and fuck everyone who disagrees.
Well, I would say to all our listeners, you should never take anything TNG says as legitimate anyway.
That's
But
true.
I disagree with you on here, and here's why. One, so it's one of those weird stoppages where I don't necessarily think that the stoppage was bad there, in that Aldo wasn't getting hit by any like real offense at that point. But at the same time, he also wasn't even trying to move, and he'd been getting his ass handed to him for a million hours in a row, it seemed like. So I also don't think that it ultimately affected the outcome of the fight. I think that likely was the end. Aldo certainly looked exhausted from getting the shit kicked out of him for the better part of 4 minutes or however the hell long Max was on him. And I'm mostly just a little bit depressed, but honestly, I'm less depressed than I thought I was going to be. And I say that because I'm kind of, this whole night just kind of blew ass. Like, I don't know how you feel about it, but I was bored for most of the card. Like, I was super impressed by Holloway's, or I mean, I guess by Holloway's third round. His first two weren't great. And I was really, obviously, incredibly impressed by Claudia Gadea's win, but I was extremely bored for a majority of this card.
Vitor Belfort versus Nate Marquardt is the new greatest of all time. That's the standard by which all fights will be judged. It's the only fight in history which has ever made me respect Vitor Belfort. Ever. I've never respected Vitor Belfort in my entire life. Actually, I kind of respected him in the Gastelum fight because that's the first time he showed mental toughness and fortitude. But this is the second time, and so he kind of proved that it wasn't a fluke, and so I respect him for that.
All right. Well, before we get too deep into that, I guess we'll just work from the top down. The main event, your winner is Max Blessed Holloway with a
Jesus.
TKO stoppage of questionable, we'll say of questionable outcome in the third round. But whether we like it or not, he is now your undisputed featherweight champion. Aside from the stoppage, what are your other thoughts on this bout, on how it was unveiling? I personally thought Aldo looked sensational in the first round. Thought clearly, I still gave him the second round, but I thought Holloway had begun shifting into a much more aggressive role, and I thought the third round was, I thought Aldo actually at the beginning of the round looked better, like he was trying to take some of that back, and then Max just did the damn thing. What were your impressions from the fight aside from the stoppage?
Oh, I'm just sad to see Aldo look like an old man, to be honest. I'm sad to see him stopped because he was dominating that fight by his much deeper skill set, because he has a much deeper skill set. Nobody's going to deny that after watching the fight. But he has a much deeper skill set than Max Holloway, and then he was 2 rounds up, arguably 1-1, and then all of a sudden he gets stopped. That's the worst case scenario for me. I'm mad. I'm furious. This is my fandom speaking, not my analyst mind speaking. I'm fucking pissed off. I don't like it. I'm angry. Fuck Max Holloway. Fuck everyone who supports Max Holloway. Jose Aldo is the greatest of all time. Fuck you.
I concur. He is the greatest of all time, and I wanted Aldo to win,
I'm so
but
mad.
I gotta I said this immediately on Twitter, and I've been thinking about it and trying to kind of wrap my head around it. And what you said's correct. Obviously, Aldo has a deeper skill set. That was just, he was flexing that on Holloway in the first couple of rounds. Holloway looked stiff. He wasn't, you know, doing the things that Max Holloway has done to become who Max Holloway is. But I am, you know, one of the narratives going into this story, this fight was, oh, well, now Jose's fighting a striker. He can unleash those leg kicks. He threw one leg kick in the entire fight, as far as I counted. And in my head, I got to think that tomorrow he's going to look back on this and go, you know, if I had worked those legs a little earlier, maybe Max doesn't start building this head of steam that he started picking up in the middle of round two. And he, you know, it slows him down, takes some of the wind out, because it's, I don't know, man. Aldo's refusal to do anything other than jab and hook was pretty interesting to me as far as a tactical decision. Although he did throw like more in combination than we've seen him recently. He did look more aggressive at stretches. I just don't know why he abandoned the leg kicks completely. And apparently that's just no longer part of his game anymore.
Here's the thing. Aldo's done. He'll never be a championship level fighter again. And it's sad because in this fight, he didn't show the depth of his skill set. He didn't show what he's capable of. He didn't show his low kicks. He didn't show like the depth of his tactical acumen. And it's sad because he will never, ever compete with a championship level fighter again. That's the truth. Ever. He looks shot. The fact that he got stopped like that makes him look shot. I'm going to throw that out there.
So I was going to get to that, and I agree and I disagree with it. I don't think that he won't ever compete with a championship level fighter, but that could just be the difference in our definitions of championship level fighters. Like if you consider Frankie Edgar a championship level fighter, I still think Jose Aldo beats Frankie Edgar. I think that may just be a difference in our definitions. I don't think he's ever holding gold again. This fight, I do think that he looked a little older. He looked much more flat-footed. I don't know if it was Max's footwork that was doing something, or his footwork looked less good to me than it normally does, and that could just be a boon on Max Holloway. I won't pretend that I had the keenest eye on this fight, or have the keenest eye for sort of immediate assessment of things like that anyway. But I did leave that thinking, maybe Jose's chin is just gone, and maybe we didn't really recognize that because he's such a defensive master and it's so hard to hit him clean. And that, you know, because he got slept by Connor, who realistically, Connor hasn't really slept anybody. Connor hits you and you fall over and then he hits you several more times. But as I'm recalling his career, he hasn't, like, that's the one real one-punch KO in his UFC run. Am I wrong on that?
Pretty much that's his one punch KO.
He hits you and then you're on skates and then he buries the nails, but he dropped Eddie five times or whatever the fuck that was. So I think it may be worth considering that Chad Mendez war took a lot out. I'm not saying he's not a hard puncher, but
he's like Golovkin.
The manner in which Aldo died.
I think of McGregor as like a Golovkin type puncher where his punching power is effortless, where he hits you and you're way more damaged than onlookers would assume you're going to be. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And that translates well as far as his KO power goes. But in terms of one punch KOs, he pretty much has none. And just like Golovkin isn't the kind of guy who's going to one punch drop you, but he is an incredibly hard puncher, just like McGregor. But more than anything else, I'm mad. I'm really mad that the fight went that way. I'm disappointed. I'm angry. This is my immediate post-fight reaction. I'll probably feel differently in a day or two, but I'm mad as fuck, Jed. I'm going to be honest with you.
Are you just mad because you're a big Jose Aldo mark?
Yes.
Or are you mad because now internet fanboys are going to say 3 rounds instead of 13 seconds?
Oh, fuck you. It's a little bit both. Jose Aldo is the greatest tactician of all time. He looked slow, he looked flat, and he still outworked Max Holloway for 2 rounds. Max Holloway isn't as good as a prime Jose Aldo. I consider that proven. Max Holloway is a bum. He's one of the worst fighters ever to hold a UFC championship. Fuck you. Fuck anyone who disagrees. Fuck everyone. Literally fuck everyone. I'm so mad right now. I'm so mad.
This is the official Naked Truth stance. Max Holloway, you're a bum. If you dislike it, feel free to come on the pod and discuss.
He's the worst fighter ever to hold the UFC belt. The worst.
Yeah, we think you're shit, and you just happen to get lucky.
Very lucky.
I will say that that finishing sequence.
He bribed John McCarthy. I'm calling that out right now. He bribed Big John McCarthy to stop that fight.
That's fair.
Fuck Max Holloway.
I think anybody with eyeballs sees the truth of your words here. The last thing I want to talk about this particular fight is, man, that finishing, not the finishing sequence because that was prolonged, but the punch that dropped, like the punching combination that dropped Aldo, he just stood still and got lit up by like a four piece, which is, I think, the first time I've ever seen that happen to Jose Aldo. Almost certainly the first time I've ever seen
that happen to Jose Aldo. He's way past his prime. The fact that he's way past his prime, obviously, and still picked Max Holloway apart for two rounds. I mean, that proves the difference between the
round was so ridiculous.
Yeah. He just destroyed Max Holloway.
He hurt Max Holloway, and I didn't even know that that was really like a thing that happened. So
yeah, it's never happened before. Nobody hurts Max Holloway. But he picked Max Holloway around apart for two rounds, way past his prime. Way past his prime, obviously. Which proves that he's a way better fighter than Max Holloway ever was when he's in his prime. Fuck Max Holloway. I'm so mad right now. And I know that all of my opinions come off like a fan who's incredibly mad. And the reason for that is that's because it's true. Yeah, exactly. I'm a fan mad.
What the fuck are we?
I'm no journalist. There's no doubt about that.
God knows we're not that.
Yeah.
All right. So on that note, do you want to see Jose Aldo hang it up? Would you, we've established that he is far past his prime and no longer really going to be competitive against the elite of the elite. Granted, 145 is sort of a thin division. It's not really, but like, I still think he probably beats a lot to most of the 145ers, but would you just like to see him hang it up and, move on to greener pastures?
I'd like to see Max Holloway become a good fighter and become the kind of fighter who won the championship not because Jose Aldo is shot, but on his own merits, because he has nothing for a prime Jose Aldo. I'm going to fanboy this podcast up until the podcast over. I don't give a fuck. People are going to be mad.
Does he have anything for Frankie Edgar?
No, fuck you. Actually, Frankie Edgar isn't that good. So he's going to be, he'll be Frankie Edgar. There's no problem there.
I was about to say, because if we can rerun this bet where I'm on the Max Holloway side instead of the Yair Rodriguez side, and you're on the Frankie Holloway, on the Frankie Edgar side, then that would just be delightful for me. I could grab one back off you.
Yeah, my name on this Zencaster, which is what we're using to record, is literally Fuck Max Holloway. So my opinions are a little bit biased right now. But yeah, Max Holloway probably beats Frankie Edgar. No doubt about that.
Oh, a little bit. And one last thing on the just thought about the main event that jumped out to me is Jose Aldo just looks like he's fucking small. Like, he looked tiny in there against Max Holloway. And I'm not sure if Max is just an enormous featherweight, but the narrative around Jose was always that he had a hard time making the cut. Seriously? He did not look like even sort of close to what we would define as a big featherweight in there, that's the first time I've ever really been stuck by that thought.
The thing about Novo and Yao is they've always been like that, like Barao and Aldo. Barao isn't a massive bantamweight. He's a big bantamweight, but he's not the kind of bantamweight that makes you think, wow, how does this guy make bantamweight? But yet he consistently struggles to make the weight. Same as Aldo. Aldo isn't a massive featherweight. McGregor was much bigger than him. Holloway was considerably bigger than him, but I don't know. I've always thought of Novo and Yao as the kind of camp where their fighters make weight, sure, but they don't understand the methods quite proficiently enough. Their weight cutting methods are kind of suspect.
I feel what you're saying. It's a man, this is such a bummer. We both talked about it beforehand. We thought that Aldo should win, our heads, and then our guts were telling us that Max was going to do it, and that's exactly what ended up happening. Which is quite depressing.
Aldo's the better technician.
Less depressing things.
Aldo's the better fighter, he's the better technician. Fuck anyone who disagrees, but he's old, his chin is kind of gone. Max Holloway beat him because he's old, and if they fought in their prime, Max Holloway would be dead because he's not as good as Jose Aldo was. That's a fact. Fuck Max Holloway. Jose Aldo is the greatest featherweight of all time, and no matter what Max Holloway does, he'll never erase that. Fuck Max Holloway. Fuck Conor McGregor. Jose Aldo is the greatest of all time.
I concur with all of those sentiments, because I think Jose Aldo is he's in my like top three or four best fighters ever. So I'm cool with that. moving on to the co-main event of the evening, not a lot of people predicted this one. I mean, most people predicted the winner, but I don't think a lot of people were in on this particular outcome. The fight between Claudia Gadelha and Karolina Kowalkiewicz, the numbers one and two best women's strawweights in the world, not named Joanna Jędrzejczyk. Claudia Gadelha just does the damn thing. Takes Kowalkiewicz down, submits her with a rear naked choke in the very first round. You know, my big issue with this fight going into it was that this was not five rounds. And damn, if I don't just look like a jackass, because Gadelha didn't even need three. What's your takeaway from this co-main event?
My takeaway is that neither of these fighters matter, and that Jose Aldo got robbed of a deserved win by Big John McCarthy, who stopped the fight too early. I'm so mad. There's no words for how mad I am right now. There's nothing else I can talk about. I'm just mad. I'm angry. I'm furious. But that said, yeah, Claudia Gadelha is a lot better than Karolina Kowalkiewicz, and that's how it played out. So, I mean, whatever. I'll talk about really? Vitor versus Marquardt, though. I'll talk about that fight.
Well, we're working our way down there. Because, honestly, there isn't much else to say about the Kowalkiewicz-Gadelha fight.
Yeah,
other than
just better. That's it.
Hey, Gadelha just beat that ass and is the second best fighter in her division and will remain so until such time as Joanna Jędrzejczyk leaves the division. And she's also fucking delightful, so that's awesome, because her post-fight interview was great, despite the fact that apparently, here's the thing I learned tonight, guys, MMA Twitter fucking hates you if you buy a damn dog. My timeline was filled with people being like, Claudia, don't buy a dog, adopt one. So that's the thing. Who knew? MMA filled with a bunch of bleeding hearts. Had no idea.
Yep. MMA Twitter is full of shitty people and their shitty opinions. I bought my dog, and I don't give a fuck. My dog's my best friend. Fuck all of you.
Yeah, my hot take in the one of my hotter takes in the world is that I'll never not buy a dog, and you can't ever make me feel bad for that particular feeling because it's my dog, and I'll do whatever I goddamn well please. So
exactly,
I'm not doing a dog to rescue somebody. This isn't a charitable event. It's something purely to make me happy. So I'll be an asshole and I'm okay with it.
My dog, I got him. He's so a King Charles. My dog is a King Charles Cavalier. I bought him and I'm incredibly glad that I did, because he's the nicest dog in the entire world.
I did not realize you had such an adorably small dog.
To be fair, he's like a giant for his breed. Like, the Cavalier is a toy breed, but he himself is massive for the breed. My dog is huge. It doesn't even make sense. It's like 28 pounds of King Charles Cavalier.
That's my grandmother actually breeds them, so...
Yeah. Then you know that 28 pounds for a Cavalier.
That's a fairly fit. He's a fat ass, is what you're telling me.
No, he's just huge. His paws are like the size of my fists. They don't even make sense. No.
You heard it here, TNT fans. The Naked Gambler, he overfeeds his dog, and he's a fat slob of a dog. That's what he has. Is your dog named Aldo?
My dog is named Faust.
Oh, I like it. That's a good dog name, actually.
It's a goddamn good dog name, no doubt about that.
It is. I give you a lot of shit, but I'll give you props on that one. Okay, fine. We can do the thing that you fucking want to do. The worst fight... the best fight. Vitor Belfort gets a charitable decision against Tate Marquardt in his hometown.
He won that fight. Fuck you. There's no doubt about it. It wasn't even close.
Well, there's no doubt that he, in fact, got the victory. I think I'm one of the few people who actually scored it for him, like in the media, but a lot of people thought that Nate Marquardt did enough to get his hand raised. What are your takeaway from the best, from what's clearly going to be fight of the night?
Vitor won, and not only that, but this is the second fight, the first one being the Gastelum fight, which has actually made me respect Vitor Belfort, because I've always thought of Vitor Belfort as an incredibly talented guy who had nothing beyond that. No mental toughness, very little in the way of skills, but he kept winning fights because he's incredibly physically talented. But this was the second fight after the Gastelum one where I thought to myself, wow, Vitor is tough. He won this fight because he's mentally tough. He won this fight because he kept pushing and he upped the ante in the third round, which That's fucking outrageous to say about Vitor Belfort. He turned up the pace in the third round. Whoever thought that they'd say that about Vitor Belfort?
Yeah, if you told me beforehand that Vitor was gonna need to win the third round to win this fight, I would have told you, well, Vitor's lost this fight. That's we'll just check on out.
Vitor by decision. What the fuck?
And I didn't check this out, but didn't he? He won the back two rounds. He didn't even win the first round, which is, if you told anybody going into this thing that Vitor Belfort is going to lose the first round of his fight to Nate Marquardt, you'd be like, well, he's just going to lose the fight, and they would have all, everybody would have felt really good. So I guess when you put it like that, 40-year-old Vitor Belfort just reinventing himself.
Toughest form of his career. Yeah, exactly. Because Marquardt took him down in the first round, and when he took him down, I thought it was completely over. I thought the fight was over. It was like, Marquardt took him down in the first round. Well, it's only going to get worse for him from here, so Marquardt wins.
What were your thoughts on that stand-up? Because a lot of Twitter was livid with the stand-up by Osiris Maya.
I remember thinking that it was really bad, but again, I'm pretty intoxicated, so I don't even remember it that well. I just remember being mad.
Damn. I'm going to have to go back and watch that, because I just felt the stand-up was inevitable and justified. Like, not justified, because in general I don't even really like stand-ups, but my recollection of it is that Marquardt took him down and literally didn't throw a punch and just did, like, a bunch of those shitty little inside shoulder shrugs. And was just like, well, if you're not even going to pretend to do offense, then what the fuck are we doing here?
I was just amazed that Vitor, like, he's the one round guy. He's the guy who finishes all his fights in the first round or he loses. And all of a sudden he loses the first round and wins the second and third and wins the decision. You have to respect him for that. You literally have to give him respect because he's evolved so much to get to this point. He's obviously worked so hard to get to the point where his MMA career matters to him, and he's not just physically tougher, he's mentally tougher. You know, he's not quitting when people are hitting him. And you got to respect him for that, because that's his MO. Historically, his MO is just quitting when shit gets hard. But when shit got hard tonight, he just kept persevering. And my God, like, I never in a million years thought I'd say that about Vitor Belfort, and that makes it way more impactful to me than it otherwise would be.
Well, it's true, and you know, this was his 25th fight in the UFC, and his first decision win in the organization. And then afterwards, I guess the other big news breaking out of this fight is that afterwards, Vitor has determined that he is no longer retiring. Going into the fight, was the storyline. Yeah, the storyline going in was that this was Vitor's last hurrah. He wanted to fight in Brazil to go out, and then shortly before that it was revealed that he still had one more fight on his UFC contract, and then he started talking that maybe he wasn't done. Brian Stann and Cage asked him, and he says, nope, you guys are gonna have to stick with me. I got five more fights. I'm gonna completely reinvent myself. five more. To be fair, he has reinvented himself, as we just discussed, so maybe the final form of 40-year-old Vitor Belfort is something else that we're not even ready for.
Historically, Vitor Belfort is the kind of guy who, he's a singularly gifted physical athlete who can knock anyone out, but he's just got nothing beyond that. Like, it's unfair to call any fighter a coward, but if you're going to call one fighter a coward, it would be Vitor Belfort, because he quits when everything is getting difficult for him at all. Yeah, Max Holloway is a coward too. The only reason he even holds the featherweight belt right now is pure cowardice and luck, because Big John McCarthy gifted him the win. But Vitor Belfort, I mean, he's gone from the kind of guy who I describe as a coward, who I consider a mentally weak guy, to I got rocked and taken down the first round, but doesn't matter, I'll come back and win the second and third. Which nobody ever, I don't care what you say, nobody thought Vitor was going to do that. Lose the first round and come back and win the second and third. You have to respect him for that. Fuck you.
I'm just going to not respect him because it'll piss you off more. And at this point, we're just playing the how mad can we get TNG this evening before he just hangs up on me.
My immediate post-fight reactions are mad as fuck. I'm mad. I'm a fanboy right now. Don't take me as a journalist. Don't take me as a Twitter user. Don't take me seriously. Just take me as a fan who's mad that Jose Aldo got robbed of a win that he deserved by a bad stopper.
I want you to know that you just said, don't take me as a Twitter user. Don't take me seriously. As if Twitter and serious go hand in hand, especially with you.
You'd be surprised, man. People take me awfully seriously on Twitter.
Oh, people are fucking dumb.
Yes, they are.
The rest of this card was exceptionally uneventful and super nobody gives a shit about. Paulo Borrachinha and Aloala Bamboge had some fun for about 6 minutes. Aloala Bamboge, the bang bust through the standing double hammer fist, which is an interesting technique to say the least.
I've been telling everyone.
And then
I've been telling everyone that Bangbos versus What's-His-Face is one of the most... You have to watch this fight because it's just two incredible athletes with incredible physical ceilings who have virtually no skill. Like, Borrachinha is fine. He has a little bit of footwork and a little bit of combination punching, but they're both terrible. They're terrible fighters with all the physical gifts in the world, and it was an amazing fight that everybody needed to see, and that's how it played out.
It was sensational. Then Yancy Medeiros knuckle dust got an early. And if we're talking about early stoppages, this one is certainly more controversial. Yancy Medeiros stops Eric Silva with a KO in round two.
I don't care
about talking about that fight.
Bad Holloway stops Matt Aldo in round two.
Oh wow, that's actually. That's depressingly close to accurate.
Depressingly close.
Oh, God, that hurts. And then my boy, he did it. He did it, mama. Rafael dos Anjos just kicks over the apple cart of World Series of Fighting prospect Marlon Moraes in exactly the fight I thought that was going to happen. To be fair, I scored the fight for Marlon Moraes. I do think Rafael dos Anjos sort of got away with one, but holy shit, this is some of the worst matchmaking the UFC's made in ages. You take a gangbusters action fighter, debut him against the most nullifying force in the division. it is just the worst idea.
Rafael dos Anjos is a striking version of Darren Helkins. He just completely shuts you down and doesn't let you do anything at all because it's so hard to hit Rafael dos Anjos cleanly. And I was vaguely lucid while watching the fight, and I remember scoring it from Moraes, but don't take that too seriously. I'm happy for this one, though, all things considered.
I know I'm a little bit personal. I'm extremely happy for him. I think everybody scored that fight from Marlon Moraes. Not to say that the fight wasn't close. It was extremely close. But, I mean, dude, he is just... And, you know, this was the fight people were looking forward to on this card other than the Holloway Aldo fight. And I was confused as to why, because, yeah, Marlon Moraes is awesome and a gangbusters action fighter. But Rafael dos Anjos is the exact opposite of an action fighter. Yeah. And this fight was never going to look anything other than it looked like this. Like, it was going to be Marlon Moraes maybe edging out or dos Anjos. It was going to be a split decision. And I'm super pumped for Rafael dos Anjos, who will never get to fight another good fighter ever again. He's only going to fight like low-end prospects at the division just to, you know, give them some seasoning, because they don't want him anywhere near a title shot, because why in God's name would you in one of their most exciting marquee divisions?
Yeah, exactly. He's just good enough to make all your good fighters look awful. TJ Dillashaw, like in the TJ Dillashaw fight, he was coming off in a close to 2 year layoff, and he still made that fight competitive.
Yeah,
TJ Dillashaw couldn't finish him. And if you're Dillashaw making...
didn't even look good. He didn't look good either, because you can't look good against him.
Everybody looks bad against Rafael dos Anjos. Why would you book anyone against Rafael dos Anjos who you don't want to lose immediately? Like, if there's somebody...
And a guy who's a known action fighter.
Exactly.
I was trying to think, like, who could they match up Justin Gaethje with at lightweight that would be similar? I know he's fighting Michael Johnson, which I actually do think is kind of a bad fight in general, when the winner of the Poirier-Alvarez fight was fucking right there to have to have Gaethje fight, and I still don't understand why that's not the fight. It's clearly the fucking fight to make. But like, who at lightweight would be similar to matching Gaethje? Like, who is that guy? I can't think.
There's no lightweight who has the depth of skill set that just neutralizes whatever you do as much as Rafael Sunsao does. Because Rafael Sunsao, in every phase, is incredibly well-rounded. He's incredibly good at every single thing that he does. But he's not, he doesn't present the most overwhelming offense, but he can neutralize anything. Anything you try to do, he can take away from you. He has the tools to take those things away from you. Anything to find success, he can strip you of that. And so it's a weird match. And the fact that Moraes looked as good as he did is actually a positive for Moraes, I think. Because people see this as him being derailed, but Rafael dos Anjos is really good. He's really fucking good. So it is what it is.
He is really good, and he cashed my bet that I had on him, so I fucks with Rafael dos Anjos tonight.
Yeah.
Other than that, the only other fight I would mention is the next fight down the card. Antonio Carlos Jr., old shoe face, submits Eric Spicely in the second round. And you should actually go back and watch that, because it's actually legitimately some of the most interesting MMA grappling I've seen in a really long time. The real reason I want to mention it, aside from the fact that it really was a really sensational grappling bout, is that the other podcast that I jump in on with Nick Baldwin from Bloody Elbow, he and the other co-host, Wes Riddle, both picked Eric Spicely to out-grapple Antonio Carlos Jr., so wow. I just want to mock them for... I mean, okay, to be fair, Wes said that he thought he could be competitive with him on the floor, and Nick said he was gonna beat him on the floor, and I flabbergastedly said, you guys know you're fucking idiots, right? And I felt extremely vindicated when Antonio Carlos Jr. literally just showed the difference between a black belt in BJJ and a world champion in BJJ. He just hustled Eric Spicely up on the floor. All credit to Eric Spicely. He did a lot better in grappling exchanges than many people would do, but Shoeface ain't nothing to fuck with on the mat, and that was awesome. Yeah. The rest of the undercard, I don't give a flying shit about. I didn't even watch half of it, because here in America, Fox Sports 1 was showing a lot of a baseball game, which is impossibly frustrating because I don't get Fox Sports 2, so I missed a lot of it and just said, fuck it. Do you have any other takeaways from the early card? Are you still hung up on Max Holloway being a cowardly piece of shit?
I woke up just in time for the main card. I didn't give a fuck about the undercard. I thought it was terrible. I didn't even watch most of it. I'm going to be honest right now. I'm not a professional journalist, so don't judge me too harshly. I just didn't watch because it was terrible. I needed sleep.
It's true, guys. He actually doesn't sleep hardly fucking ever. It's kind of insane.
Yeah. I run on less sleep than any member of the MMA media. I'm going to say it right now. Nobody runs on less sleep than me. I'm averaging 2 to 3 hours per night to balance all my responsibilities. Fuck you.
Yeah, you guys wonder why it's so fucking hard to get a consistent podcast out. There you go. Do you have any more takeaways from this card? Do you want to yell some more about Max Holloway, or should we just close it up for the night?
I think we can close up there. I think if we go on any longer, I'm just going to sort of verbally fillet Vitor Belfort too much while simultaneously just shitting on Max Holloway. Fuck Max Holloway. Literally the worst fighter ever to compete in MMA. Jose Aldo was the greatest of all time. It was a fluke. Fuck Max Holloway. Fuck Big John McCarthy. Those are my closing thoughts.
So is it safe to say that Max Holloway is an enemy of the show now?
Oh yeah, huge enemy of the show. Literally the worst fighter ever to compete in MMA. The Cody McKenzie of the featherweight division.
And certainly the worst one to hold a belt. Max, you heard it here first. We're calling you out. You're a coward and a piece of shit, and you're the worst fighter to ever hold a belt. And you're a designated enemy of the pod. And if you want to come and defend yourself, feel free to let us know. We're happy to have you on to verbally castrate you for all your failings, both personal and professional.
Absolutely, my friend.
And that will do it for this quick quick little brazen recap. We will try and get you out of pod this week as well, where we will talk about I think there's an upcoming fight card with Mark Hunt versus Derek Lewis, and I'm certain that there will be news coming around, and maybe we can get a more sober, less vitriolic Naked Gambler opinions on some things when he's had time to cool off. But fair bet that he's still just going to hate everything.
Immediate post-fight reaction shows are the best time to find me mad as fuck, because after fights, I'm always mad as fuck before I cool off. There's always fights where I think to myself, that was a bullshit stoppage, that was a bullshit ending, whatever, and I'm just furious about them for about 6 hours, and then the next morning I think, oh, that's fine. And that's probably how I'll be next morning. I'll think the Holloway stoppage was fine, but right now I want Big John McCarthy to die. If any of you are in the position to kill Big John McCarthy or Max Holloway, I'm fully endorsing you doing it. Fuck those guys. Jose Aldo is the greatest fighter of all time. Fuck you. Fuck everyone. Fuck Jed. Fuck this podcast. That's all I got to say.
As our legal representative, I will say that we do not endorse the murder of any person, real or imagined.
I do. Fuck this guy. Don't listen to him. I endorse it.
We do not. I'm going to put a disclaimer scrolling across the bottom of this video. It fucking runs, you asshole. But yeah, so that's it for us. Thanks for tuning in. I hope to have this up real soon so you people still fiending for a post-fight reaction can listen to this after you listen to Luke probably fillet Max Holloway, because Luke is a giant piece of shit who is almost as big a piece of shit as Max Holloway. It's been real, guys. Thanks. I'm Jed Meshew. He's the Naked Gambler. We'll catch you later.